everyone. In this session, we are going to discuss about the join operation in SQL. Sometimes there is a requirement when we need to retrieve data from multiple table. So in that situation, we need to join the multiple table together so that we can retrieve the data from them. And for that task, join clause is present in the structured query language. If we take an example of employee and department table here, so there is a requirement of a query. In query, we want employee name from employee table and department name from department table. So we have to join these two tables together to satisfy the requirement of query. Now, as we have a department ID as a common attribute in this two table, so we can join both the table together on the basis of the common attribute department ID. And we will write the query as select ename dname from employee department, where employee name equal to John. Suppose we need to retrieve the record of John. And employee.departmentID is equal to department.departmentID, and this is the join condition. This is the condition which is satisfied on the basis of the common attribute among these two tables. Now, there are the different type of join operation which is used in the SQL. The first one is the self-join. Self-join is based on the single table. Second is the cross-join. Cross-join is the join operation in which we are not going to put any condition. So, the query will display all possible combination from the both table. And that is similar to the Cartesian product operation in a set theory. Next is the natural join. Natural join is based on the common column present in the both table, and we need not put the join condition explicitly. So it is known as natural join. And the last one is the equi-join. Equi-join is the most predominantly used join in the SQL, as it use equal to operator, so it is known as equi-join. For example, this example is the example of equi-join because we have used the equal to operator in the join condition. Now, equi-join can be of two types, inner join and outer join. Inner join takes only common record from both the table. It is also similar to the intersection operation in a set theory. Second is the outer join. Outer join can be of left outer join, right outer join, and full outer join. In left outer join, when we combine two table A and B, so we want the record of first table. So it is known as left join. In left join, again there is a two variation. We want only the record of first table, or we want the record of first table as well as the common among the both table. Next one is the right join. In right join, again we are going to take the table records of second table, and there might be the two situation again. We need only the record of second table, or we need the all record of second table. It might be the situation that some records might be common among A and B. So this is the two variation of left outer join and right outer join. Similarly, full outer join has also a two variation. In full outer join, we are going to take the all record from the both table, and that is similar to the union operation in a set theory. And again, it has a second variation where we are going to exclude the common record among both the table. So this is all about the join operation in a SQL. Now we are going to conclude this topic. Thank you.